Welcome back. This is study session 2, titled Oscillation. This study session 2 is the continuation of study session 1. In study session 1, you have been introduced to the basic concepts of oscillatory motions, which are the periodic and the simple harmonic motion. But in this study session, our focus will be on how energy is stored in the body performing simple harmonic motion, and we will discuss the most common type of oscillatory motion, which is the motion of a simple pendulum ball. At the end of this study session, you are expected to be able to 1. Describe how energy is stored in a simple harmonic motion. You should be able to discuss simple harmonic motion of a pendulum bulb, and you should be able to explain free, damped, and forced oscillation. What are the energy that is stored in the body of a body performing simple harmonic motion? To study the energy stored in the body performing simple harmonic motion, you need to first consider all the forms of energy it can have. The energy such a body can have are the kinetic energy and the potential energy. How do you calculate the kinetic energy? The kinetic energy of a body performing simple harmonic motion is the same as the kinetic energy of the mass attached to such a body. For example, in study session 1, we talk about a mass spring system in which a body of mass M is attached to it. So we can say that the kinetic energy of such a body is the kinetic energy of the mass attached to the spring, which can be calculated with this formula: half m omega square a square sine square omega t plus phi. The potential energy of such a system is the same as the potential energy of the spring, which can be calculated as half kx square. And when you apply mathematical equivalent, potential energy is equal to half k a square cos square omega t plus phi. The kinetic energy of a body attain its maximum value, and the potential energy attain its minimum value when the displacement of such a body is zero. Likewise, the potential energy of such a body attain its maximum value, and kinetic energy attain its minimum value when the displacement of such a body is maximal. So we can say that the maximum speed of the body oscillating can be calculated by kinetic energy is equal to the total energy minus the potential energy. After applying mathematical deductions, we can calculate the speed represented by V as plus or minus the square root of K divided by M into bracket A square minus X square. For a system to execute simple harmonic motion, it must have two parts. One, it must have where it can store potential energy, like a spring. And the other part is that the other capable part of storing kinetic energy, such as the mass. In this slide, let us look at this simple pendulum bulb. The motion of the bulb of a simple pendulum bulb is shown in this figure. In order to prove this fact, we should consider a simple pendulum bulb having a bulb of mass M and the length of the pendulum is L. Assuming that the mass of the spring of the pendulum is negligible, when the pendulum is at rest at position A, the only force acting on the pendulum is its weight and the tension in the spring. When the bulb of the simple pendulum is displaced from its main position to another new position, say B, and released, it vibrates to and fro from its main position. Suppose that at this instant, the bulb is at point B. So from this figure, the forces acting on the bulb are 1. The weight of the bulb, W, acting vertically downward, and the tension in the string, T, acting along the spring. So the weight of the bulb can be resolved into two rectangular components. 1. The W cos theta along the string, and W sin theta are perpendicular to the string. Recall from the periodic equation of a mass spring system that period T is calculated by 2 pi, the square root of m divided by k. Substituting k is equal to mg over l into this equation, you will have T is equal to 2 pi square root of l over g. And since T is equal to 1 over frequency, this implies that the frequency of a simple pendulum can be calculated as 1 over 2 pi g divided by l. Now, let's talk about the types of a simple harmonic motion. We have three types of a simple harmonic motion. We have the free oscillation type, we have the damped oscillation type, and we have the forced oscillation type. What is the difference between these three types of oscillations? In the free oscillation, the amplitude remains constant as time passes. There is no damping. This type of oscillation will occur in theory, since in practice, a simple harmonic motion will always have some damping. The displacement will follow the formula x is equal to r sine omega t, where r is the amplitude, which is sometimes denoted by a. Then, what are the instances of free simple harmonic motion? If two simple harmonic motion acts along the same direction with the same frequency, then their resultant is a simple harmonic motion with the same frequency along that line. The amplitude will be constant, but will depend on the phase difference between the two SHM. But if the frequency of the two simple harmonic motion are different, but they still act along the same line, then beats will be produced, and the variation in the amplitude depending on the difference in the frequency. The third instance is if two simple harmonic motion act in perpendicular direction. With this kind of instance, there are two possibilities. The first one is if their frequency are the same and of equal magnitude, then a phase difference of 0 will give a straight line. A phase difference of pi over 2 will give a circle, while a phase difference of pi will give 0 oscillation. But if the frequencies are different but of equal amplitude, this will give Lissajous figure. Three examples of Lissajous figure will be shown in the next slide, but the number of loops in the x and y directions can be counted, and this will give the frequency ratio of two simple harmonic motion. This is the frequency figure of a Lissajous figure. What is a damped oscillation? A damped oscillation is an oscillation where energy is taken from the system, so the amplitude decays. This figure depicts a damped oscillation. Types of damped oscillation. We have the natural damping and we have the artificial damping. But before we go into that, damping is also important in weighing machine, such as in shop or a checkout at the supermarket, where a true reading of mass m of an object placed on scale pan is needed. Natural damping. What an example of this type of damping are internal forces in a fluid or in a spring that is exerting a viscous drag. But artificial damping are damping of like electromagnetic damping in galvanometers, like shock absorber in cars. Artificial damping can be light, in which case the system oscillates about a midpoint. Forced oscillation. An oscillation which is kept going by a periodic driving force is called forced oscillation. An example is a car engine. These are vibrations that are driven by an external force. A simple example of forced oscillation is a child swing. As you push it, the amplitude increases. Another example is the marching of a battalion of an army over a bridge. The regular marching gives the bridge a forced vibration. Examples of forced oscillation includes 1. Shivering to eat in response to cold. Expansion of the chest while you are breathing. Beating of the heart and dilation and contraction of the arteries. These are all examples of forced oscillation. In each example of forced oscillation highlighted, we can see that the driving force is provided by the muscles. When this system relaxes due to high or low potential energy states, their mechanical energy is decreased by the work done. The system are highly damped and require the driving force to cause motion. Thank you for listening. See you in the next class.